Adam. Trip to Borrego Springs and a trailer and a Nissan Frontier for your showcase. $28,000 was your bid. Actual retail price? $32,836. You beat her by $101. You won by $101. Man.
Oh my God.
That was close, folks. $101 difference between him and her.
Jackie Fuchs is our champion. As we discovered on yesterday's program, she was once Malibu Barbie and was also a performer in an all-girl rock band?
I was the bass player in the 70s all-female rock band, The Runaways.
Wow. So wait a minute. You were in a rock band playing bass. You were Malibu Barbie, and now you're an attorney and a writer. How did you make that switch at some point?
I just get bored easily, I guess.
If you have musical talent, it is often said that you have a what for music. An eye, an ear, a hand, a dislocated shoulder.
That would be B, Regis.
Ear. Got it for $200. Of course, you gotta have that ear for the music.
James Brown, a little wicked, James is spinning. All right, 1,500. Now pick a letter that we can find up there. Go ahead.
A G.
Yes, there is a G. $1,500, guys.
What about a vowel?
Sure. Yeah? Okay. I. Yeah, I heard I, and we'll fill in some I. Now.
Yeah. Name something that's slippery and hard to hold on to. Iced tea. First thing came to my mind.
He's originally from Alberta, Canada. He's also an expert hockey player. He earned his nickname Lionheart from his ruthless attacks on his opponents. Now, if you're one of his fans, you're one of the thousands of Jericho-olics. Meet Chris Jericho. Come on, Chris.
Eddie, let's see what happened to Chad. Chad? With his glasses affixed firmly upon his nose.
I did the Krypton to Superman route.
Oh. How much did you wager? 35, which leaves you with 40, which means a two-headed monster. Get it? Nice game, Chad. The two-headed monster headed towards the wheel.
Normally, I wouldn't listen to it. It's patronizing rubbish.
Yeah. Alan?
Well, actually, I was surprised that Johnny, very early in the Sex Pistols' career, he delivered the same kind of thing.
Yes, 4 years ago. Big
yes,
difference.
That's fine. Four years ago, that's fine, John. And I'm quite sure that you're very proud of what you did 4 years ago. And I'm sure that these boys are equally as proud as what they've done here in 1979.
But you know, the girls working in the production office here and our PAs and everyone working behind the scene, they bust their butts on this show.
Absolutely.
And they come in, good morning, their hair is wrapped and everybody's in black. He's like, how you doing? I'm okay. Brett Michaels is on the show. I didn't know half of these girls had booties like that. I didn't know we had so many booties and boobies and shorts up to here. It's like, oh, hi, good morning. Here's your coffee.
Oh, I was really jealous when I walked in here. I thought, this is a hot show to work on. You're a lucky man.
It's all because of you.
Thank you.
You always disagree.
I can tell you why.
You think I'm a pretty smart guy, I hope, right?
Actually, about as smart as they come.
Okay. Why did you bring back two people that I can't fire? I can't fire them. Omarosa did nothing wrong, and I think you'd probably agree with that. Jenny really did nothing wrong. She didn't deserve to be here. I have no choice. You know that. Gene, you're fired.
I respect your decision.